What's up internet, I'm Manish from RebellionRadio.com. Till so far we have learned how to export table space, full database, tables and schemas. And in today's Oracle Database tutorial, we are going to learn how to import tables using IMPDB data pump import. In this tutorial, you will also learn how to rename a table during an IMPDB data pump import operation, which means how you can make a copy of a table using IMPDB import. So without further ado, let's start the tutorial. Before moving ahead, I would suggest you to watch tutorial 55 on how to export tables for the better understanding of the concept. Okay, first I will connect to my database using HR user. Here I am. Here in this HR schema, I have a table by the name of superheroes and this table has rows of data also. Let me quickly show you. As you can see here, to save the time, I have already exported this table. And here is the location of dump files and log files created by expdb data pump export. We will use this superhero.dmp dump file to perform the import of superheroes table. You can watch tutorial 55 if you want to learn how to export tables. Now, to demonstrate how to import a table using IMPDB data pump import, let's first drop the table superhero. For that, let's come back to our SQL developer and now we will drop the table superheroes. Table superheroes dropped. Let's execute this select query to ensure that table has been dropped. Error in result proves that the table superheroes is dropped, as you can see here. Now, let's come to the command prompt and try to recover this superheroes table by importing it using IMPDB data pump import. Here we are. Keep in mind that here you can only execute IMPDB data pump import on command prompt. So if you are on SQL prompt, then come out of it first and then write your import command. As you can see, I'm already on my C prompt. Let's write the IMPDB import command. Let's take a deep look at this command. If you have watched my previous tutorial, then you must be aware of most of these parameters. But still, command starts with IMPDB, which is a data pump utility provided by Oracle to load the data from dump files created by expdb export utility in the target system. Mind here, IMPDB data pump import utility can only import or load the data from dump files, not from any other files. Next is the login of the user who wants to import the data. And here, in our case, it's HR user. Next, we have directory parameter. Using this parameter, you can specify the default location where IMPDB data pump import can find the dump files to import the data. As I have already explained in the previous data pump export tutorials that the value of this parameter is always a directory object rather than the path of the directory. In my case, the value is exp underscore table, which is a directory object which I created in my tutorial 55 on how to export tables. Next parameter is dump file. Using this parameter, you specify the name of the dump file from which IMPDB can import the data you want. In our case, this data is the table superhero. Similarly, using log file parameter, you can generate and specify the name of your log file. Log files are created by IMPDB import utility. I always recommend you to use this parameter because if there is an error, then you can track them using log files. And the last parameter is tables. Using this parameter, you can specify the names of tables you want to import from the dump file. For example, here I have specified superheroes, which is the name of the tables which we want to import. Okay, let's come back to our command prompt. Here we are. Let's execute this command. Import is successful. Now let's come back to our SQL developer and see whether we got our superheroes table with all its data or not. Let's again execute our first query where we are selecting everything from our table superheroes. As you can see, we have successfully imported our superheroes table using IMPDB data pump import. Okay, these are the simple steps explaining how to import a table. Next, I will show you how you can rename a table using IMPDB data pump import. Say you already have a table and you don't want to delete it and still want to import the same table with the different name. Or in simple words, you want to make a copy of the table. In this case, what you can do is that you can use remap underscore table parameter provided by IMPDB data pump import utility of Oracle database. Let's see how we can rename a table using remap underscore table parameter of IMPDB data pump import. For the demonstration, I will again perform the import of the same table superheroes with the different name, say superheroes underscore copy. For that, we again have to use our command prompt and here we are. Command for importing the table superheroes will remain the same. We just have to add an additional parameter remap underscore table. Let's see how. Okay. Remap underscore tables parameter takes two values. First is the old name of the table along with the schema, and the second one is the new name of the table which you want to give. Both the names are separated using colons. Let's execute this command. Import is successful. Now let's jump over SQL Developer and see whether we have successfully imported the superhero tables with a new name or not. Here is the structure of the table which indicates that we have imported the superhero table with new name superhero copy. Let's check the data inside the table. And here is the data. That means we have successfully imported the entire superheroes table with the data. For all the commands which I have performed in this tutorial and in-depth knowledge of this concept, you can visit my blogs. Link is in the description box. Hope you learned something and find this tutorial helpful. Please hit the thumbs up button. You can also comment and give me your feedback. Please share this video and don't forget to subscribe. And if you want to connect with me, then all my contact information are in the description box. That's it for today. We'll be back soon with another tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.